The year 2022 is coming to its end, which means Christmas is coming. I'm sure some of you have thought of giving yourself or someone close to you a 3D printer for Christmas. Before you go shopping, please watch this video. First, let's talk about what a 3D printer can be good for. With an inexpensive 3D printer, we get the ability to upgrade our 3D printer with printed upgrades. We will look at that in another video. You can print toys, gifts, and dust collectors. I personally prefer to print useful prints, as you can actually see from my other videos. But there is no better feeling than printing your own 3D model. 3D printing is also useful for prototyping or models where you want to be able to make changes frequently. This will be appreciated by a lot of companies when developing their products. As you can see, a 3D printer really has a lot of uses. It's basically up to you how you use it. In this video, we take a look at the Creality Ender 3 3D printer. The reason I chose this 3D printer is mainly because of its price and incredibly large global community. While I was working on this video, I was able to buy a new one from the Czech Republic for about $131. $131 for a 3D printer? That's practically daylight robbery. Let's now take a look at the prices of other 3D printers. As you can see, this 3D printer is really cheap. This printer has been on the market since 2018. There have only been a few small updates since then. But don't expect better print quality or a quiet printing experience. For that, you will have to help yourself in a different way, but that's not what today's video is about. You can find videos about a few upgrades on my channel. A handy person can build it in about 1 hour. A clumsy person can do it in about 1.5 hours. I did it in 1 hour and I was playing on my phone while I did it, but not that I want to brag. Of course, I followed my instructions during the build, which you can find at the link below the video. After running the first print, a lot of people are surprised by the noise level, but also the very good print quality. And also that the included filament is not always enough for your first print. The noise is not that bad. During printing, it is around 52 decibels. Here you can see the first print on this 3D printer. The included white filament was unfortunately not enough, so I used blue PLA filament from Filamentum. For a very first print, this print actually doesn't look bad at all. Considering the price of this 3D printer, this print is actually pretty damn good. I decided to reprint this dock, but this time with a different configuration. I actually used the profile for this printer that you can find in Prusa Slicer. The filament I used was orange PLA from printed filaments. The chosen color makes the details of the print very easy to see. Here is a sample of some older prints made on this 3D printer. I don't know about you, but I would be jumping for joy if my first 3D printer was printing this nice. You may be thinking, why would anyone want to buy another and more expensive 3D printer when this one is actually sufficient? This printer is sufficient, but far from perfect. For example, its improved version, Creality Ender 3 Pro, solves several imperfections. One improvement was moving this fan to the bottom of the printer, where there is no risk of damaging it. The sometimes noisier fan on the power supply has been improved by replacing the entire power supply with a quality branded one. Last but not least, the Y-axis profile has been replaced with a wider one. This makes the Y-axis even a bit more stable. But it does beg the question, Do you find the price difference acceptable given the same print quality and slightly lower noise? Well, it's the same with basically any other 3D printer. Some have extra quiet operation where you really hardly hear the printer move. Others have, for example, different axis movement, touchscreen, filament sensor, direct extruder, or automatic calibration. You can have most of these improvements on this 3D printer as well. It may cost some money and time, but financially it will still be cheaper than buying a printer with these functionalities. My older videos will help you with some of these. Some things you will have to figure out on your own or ask the community for help. But remember that even the impossible is possible and that asking for help is the human thing to do. If you are interested only in 3D printing and don't want to deal with the different calibrations of the printer or its construction, I would recommend to pay a little more for the printer. We will look at some of the improvements and basic steps with Slicer in another video. The purpose of this video was pretty simple. I wanted to justify to myself the purchase of another 3D printer. That printer was the Ender 3. I also wanted to show you that a 3D printer doesn't have to cost a lot of money.